Kanye. What do you say about Kanye? A lot. Today he says he wants to end the rift between Colin Kaepernick and President Trump by setting up a meeting. Yesterday, while wearing a red Trump hat, he tweets he wants to abolish the 13th Amendment. You know, the one that ended slavery. That was after changing his name early Saturday to, I don't know if it's Ye or Ye, it's Y-E, I don't know what it is. And later that same night, giving several bizarre performances on Saturday Night Live, one where he ranted about Trump and slavery and the media and plantations, to name a few. Chris Rock was in the audience. He recorded it and posted it on social media. A lot of people did.
There's so many times I talk to, like, a white person about this, and I say, how could you like Trump? He's racist. Well, if I was concerned about racism, I would have moved out of America a long time ago.
You see, they laughing at me. You heard them, they scream at me. They bully me. They bullied me backstage. They said, don't go out there with that hat on. They bullied me backstage. I think the universe has balance. 90% of news are liberal. I am kind of free. I thought this country said I could be me.
Okay, so it was very uncomfortable. The host was Adam Driver. He left the stage. You could see the cast members were, some of them were like, just had their heads down. They don't let you leave the show until it's over, and that's 1 a.m. Eastern. This went on after the show, and people wanted to get up, including us, because we didn't want to listen to that bullshit, and they wouldn't let us out. So Van Jones, Nina Turner, Alice Stewart, and Steve Cortez are all here. Thank you so much for joining us. Van, I was in the audience at SNL. The worst of it happened after the credits rolled. The cast was uncomfortable, as well as the audience. Van, was this a publicity stunt?
You know, it's hard to know. I don't necessarily think so. I think that, and I just talked to Kim Kardashian earlier today, I think that he is trying to take a stand in his own mind for independence of thought. I think that he fundamentally feels that there's too much of a restriction.
Did on, Kim say that what, to you?
So you asked the question. Do I think it's a publicity sign? I think he, in his own mind, is authentically trying to make a point that I think he's making very, very badly, and I think he's making it in a way that makes it impossible for people to actually take what he's saying seriously. But I don't think that it's. I don't think he's cooking up something in a laboratory to keep himself in the news. I think he actually believes that there is a suppression of thought, and he wants to be able to take whatever independent stand he wants to take, and that's what he's trying to do.
Okay. All right, Nina. What do you think? Does he need a lesson in Black history? What do you think of it, what Van said, too?
Yeah, very much so. I mean, I agree with Van. I don't believe it's a publicity stunt. He doesn't need to do that. He has, you know, all of the cachet that is necessary to get any message across that he wants. But, you know, in some ways, there are things that are sacred in this country. And talking about the history and the legacy of slavery and bigotry and what Africans and then later African-Americans, their descendants, had to endure in this country, the taking away of their humanity, is something that we just don't play with. And so for Kanye to talk about abolishing the 13th Amendment to the Constitution, which was the amendment that abolished slavery in this country, and to talk about those issues in such a flippant way, just is not the right thing to do. He doesn't understand the legacy of that, and also how it continues to move and feed in this country even to this day.
But Nina, he said that he was trying to make more of a point about, you know, what
prisons.
About prisons, but again,
well, just make that point, Don.
Exactly.
Just make the point. Don't play with it. Chattel slavery is not to be played. You know, don't play with it.
I agree with you. I agree with you, Nina. Yeah. But just for people at home who may not be following this, the 13th Amendment abolishes slavery except for people in prison. And
yes,
so what he was trying to say, well, you know this obviously, Nina. But what he was trying to say is, you know, let's also give freedom to people who have been incarcerated, et cetera. But again, he's trying to make at least an arguably good point very, very badly.
Don, I think there's a lot to unpack in what he said. Clearly, he touched on many different topics, but one that really resonated with me, and I think a lot of people that may or may not watch Saturday Night Live, is the overall tone that liberals and those on the left in the Big Apple and Hollywood, even though I know this is filmed in the heart of New York City in Manhattan, those on the left often try to dictate how people think, what they wear, what they see, what they watch on television, how they hear their music. And that was the point he was trying to make, I think, overall, is that don't be brainwashed by the entertainment industry. And he even mentioned those in the news.
Alice, you don't think people on the right do the same thing, especially when it comes to religion, how you should feel about God, what you should be able to do with your body, how you should feel about the Second Amendment, how you should feel about a lot of things. Don't you think the right does the same thing? But no one really calls him out for that. I mean, isn't that more restrictive by telling people what they can do with themselves and how they should think about who they should love and who they can be able to marry?
Look, he's specifically talking about the liberal media and entertainment, and specifically pointing out, look, I'm wearing this MAGA hat backstage at SNL, and they're trying to tell me to take it off. They're trying to tell me what to wear and what to say. He's calling out what he sees as inaccuracies or trying to sway the viewing public when it comes to the entertainment industry. And those on the right don't have that avenue. They don't have a Saturday Night Live. They don't have Hollywood in New York. And he's specifically calling that out and also making the point. One thing I disagree on, he's saying don't so much follow your heart or your head. I think you should be able to follow your heart and your head and do things, whether you're making a political statement or entertainment, doing it from the heart and from your head at the same time.
And there are plenty of conservatives in Hollywood, by the way. But Steve, go ahead.
Well, there's not plenty, but and to that point, Don, I think it's telling that in describing his statements, you called it a rant, you called it bullshit, you called it bizarre. I don't think you say any of those terms when leftists in Hollywood get up at every single award show.
Okay, let me stop. Every point. Let me go. Every point. Okay, so that point, you're wrong, because in order not to be a rant, right, it would have to make sense. What he said did not make sense. He kept throwing up topic after topic and not explaining. No, it didn't make sense. And you weren't there. You didn't hear the whole thing. What you heard were snippets on the internet. You didn't hear the entire thing.
I heard the entire thing. Yes, I did, so, Don. Right. How do you know what I heard or didn't hear? I heard the whole thing, Don. And let me tell you, you know what I heard? I heard him talk about the intolerance of the left. And I heard him say that they demand conformity. The
if
worst
you
kind
think
of
Saturday Night Live is the left and they're intolerant, then why would they invite him there? You think they're stupid? They don't know what Kanye's going to do? You don't think Kanye did all of that in rehearsals before the show? The whole entire week of the show, people were tweeting out, Kanye has lost his mind. He's wearing a Kaepernick shirt and a Donald Trump hat. You don't think they knew that? So why would they invite him there if they didn't want that message to get out?
Don, did you invite me here to answer questions or just to talk?
No, I invited you here to tell the truth, and you're not being honest. But go on.
Wait, what lie did I tell? What lie did I tell?
You said he made sense. He did not.
He made perfect
you,
sense.
You
to me.
Called. You way, said that they were the liberals did not want his did not want him getting his voice out and what he said to get out. They invited him there and gave him the platform.
No, they did not give him the platform. They did not for his speech about. And look, what he talked about is true. When he said that 90% of performers, 90% of media are uniform, and they are uniform on the left, and they're uniform in their derision for Donald Trump and for his supporters. And what he's saying is, which I think is an important message,
is that a scientific, mathematical fact about 90%?
We people of color have been taken for granted by the Democratic Party for decades, and it has not resulted in the security and prosperity of our communities. It's time to try something different. And he, as an artist and a businessman, is saying, I am willing to listen to Donald Trump, partly because of the early results that are greatly increasing the prosperity and security of minority communities. You know, that MAGA hat should stand for minorities are great again.
Because I don't think
Hispanic
the early
excuse me?
I mean, the African-American community.
Minorities
I mean,
are great
only,
again. Oh, my God. Go ahead, Nina.
I must
again.
Call on
That's
Jesus
the new
right about
MAGA.
Now. And it's, I must call
and
on
it's
Jesus.
Because it's because
what are
of the
you
policies
talking about?
Of Donald Trump that are unleashing entrepreneurialism, that are unleashing prosperity and optimism in the land with consumer confidence at 18 years.
The challenges in the African American community are systemic. Yeah. It is not just about one president. It is systemic in this country. There was a study that showed that there would take 228 years for the average African American to catch up with the average wealth of the average white American. So we're talking about systems that are bigger than one president, and that's also bigger than Kanye West. And the point about the unemployment rate, yeah, there's no doubt that the unemployment rate is lower, but when you look at the quality of jobs, and I have traveled to almost 40 states in this country talking to people from all walks of life, and guess what? They're still suffering, and African Americans are still suffering especially. So this one president hasn't changed anything, because it's gonna take America to have some real truth and reconciliation. And that cannot just be laid at the feet of the Democrats. Although I do agree with Kanye in that the Democratic Party in some ways have definitely taken the African-American community for granted. But make no mistake, the Republican Party is not the Republican Party of Lincoln. It is not the radical Republicans of yesterday. Make no mistake. So don't even try to hold on to that. Let's be honest about what's going on in this country.
Van Jones.